Alright, today I'm joined by Perri Perri Shakes-Drayton, brilliant athlete for Great Britain, and she's going on the ice. Yeah.
It's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you, thank you for having me. It's a pleasure.
So, you've had such a brilliant career so far. What does the future hold for you next season on track?
So, we have the Commonwealth Games in April.
Yeah.
So I'm working towards that. I've been selected as an individual for the 400 and the 4x4 relay. Okay. That's exciting time to me. Plus, we have the European Championships in Berlin, which is in August, I believe. So my eyes are kind of set on making them championships.
Those are the two goals at the moment.
Okay. Yeah.
And obviously, dancing on ice. How's the training going for that?
Yes, so off the track, I'm actually training for Dance on Ice.
Yeah.
That comes, the first live show gets aired on the 7th of January.
Yeah.
I mean, that's a total, completely new world for me. Different skills. For a start, I'm on the ice rink on two blades. And from the time you get on the ice, you start moving. So it's like, there's a lot more thought process goes into the skating. Because obviously it's a new skill for me. I did know the basics, going forward and backwards, because I did used to actually train at Lee Valley Ice Rink.
Not train,
I used to go there with my cousins, used to go like night skating.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was a cool thing to do, but now I'm actually learning the technical side of things and actually learn how to skate properly.
Okay, okay. So back to the track again. In terms of next season, do you see the British record as something that you want to aim for?
I'm not going to put my expectations too high.
Yeah.
You know what? I just want to actually be back to where I was before, even better.
Yeah.
You know, 2017, it's been a comeback year for me.
Yeah.
You know, to have the British best back on, that to me was an achievement that I thought may not ever happen because I was told that, you know, this is, it's often, could be a case where you don't make it back to the world-class stage.
Yeah.
So I want to just build on, you know, 2017 and hopefully go for the best and see what I can do, really.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what's your most memorable moment in track and field? Because obviously that's your darkest moment that day.
Most memorable is always going to be 2013,
yeah.
The European Indoor Championships. At the time I was a 400 metre hurdler.
Yeah.
And I was doing the indoor championships, and there's no hurdles in for the 400 meters, so we had to do the 400. And Chris said, "Right, we're gonna go for it," and we ended up coming back with, you know, two gold medals, one in individual, and one in the relay. And I was like, "Boy, I've come out of doing it. It's not my event, but I've managed to come out with two gold medals." So then that gave me the extra confidence.
Yeah,
for the outdoor season.
So would you consider going to the 400 hurdles again? Or is it something you just know you can't do?
No, I thought I would love to do it again.
Yeah.
I would love to. The way my body's feeling, I would love to go over the hurdles again, but Chris is like, nah.
Nah? Well, you would love to.
I would love to. I think everybody else would love to see me doing it again.
Yeah.
I did enjoy doing the 400 meter hurdles because to me you had something to always look forward to and work towards.
Yeah.
Instead of the 400, you kind of just run, you try and break down the race.
Yeah.
But the 400 hurdles, you had 10 hurdles to kind of make a difference.
Judging.
Yeah.
So in terms of dancing on ice, which one's the hardest training?
Okay, for this. That's nice. The sessions could be 3 hours long, but I don't train that long. But it's definitely the skating's a lot more harder.
Yeah.
Athletics is second nature to me. I get on the track, Chris tells me what distance I'm going to run, I know how to judge it.
Yeah.
But I know I'm going to be hurting after my session.
Like today.
Yeah, like today. Excuse how I look, yeah. Sorry, but this is called working hard, yeah. And then, but the skating, God, there's so much they give. Like, one thing is like the arm positioning, like holding good form and posture.
Yeah.
I haven't got a wrong. Okay, you gotta have good form in athletics, but you have to look elegant in the skate. I don't look elegant. The facial expressions, you know, if you make a mistake, I'm trying to not show it, but it shows all on my face. Footwork, there's so much and so much information. And you got to remember the routine as well. There's a routine I'm learning at the moment.
So do you feel that it's harder to learn like the routines than actually to compete on a track for a competition.
Yeah.
By far.
Yeah.
Wow. Simple as that.
You're changing direction.
Yeah.
With the skating. Yeah, what's the next thing to come? Running.
Yeah. I love your fashion and everything that you're doing in terms of fashion outside of the sport. Do you see that as a career that you'll go into after?
I mean, I'm always one who loves to dress up. I mean, when I get an opportunity to go somewhere, I'm like, okay, let's come for the outfit now. You know, I'm around my family who are like kind of free-spirited and like, go out there. And, no matter wherever we're going, you've got to dress up.
Yeah, yeah.
I do take my appearance, like, you know, quite seriously, excuse today. Sometimes you've got to just look natural. but I would love to. I would love to go into... When I say I'd love to... you know, if there's opportunities to walk a catwalk or something, I'd love to do that. I'm always reading a magazine, getting some, like, what's hot at the moment.
Yeah.
But even, like, taking that opportunity of doing Dance on Ice, I kind of just want to appeal to a different audience.
Yeah.
Yes, I have the athletics audience and fans, but I just want to show people a different side to me. So with the skating, it's going to be an opportunity for me to look kind of glamorous.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, my personality will, and hopefully will show as well, you know. So that... There is a reason as well why I'm doing the show, because I'm now thinking about what could be my next career path.
Yeah.
Because obviously I'm not going to be an athlete for the rest of my life.
Yeah, of course. So who dresses better, you or Coach Zaha?
Zaha doesn't know how to look good though. When he comes out, even he tries to look a bit smart with his athletics gear. He does like to look smart, and when he's out of his athletics, because I'm like, alright, so I put the colours well together, good. But I'm gonna take props for that.
Because I heard there's a bit of banter between the two of you.
Oh, he loves it when I spot he's got a new item of clothing on. Yeah. He likes getting my approval. Obviously, he must rate my fashion sense, because he's like, alright, Shakes first. He gives him a little boost. So, yeah.
Okay, so what's your food intake like at the moment for the training that you're doing, because you're mixing two sports at the same time?
Yeah, so I mean, I'm not someone who's ever been shy, and I never shy away from food. I'm always hungry, you know. But because of the intensity of this side of training, obviously it's winter training, you know, it's a lot of endurance, you know, and the skating, I'm always hungry, so my intake's food. Yeah, I have to have snacks with me, fluids with me, because I'm burning a lot more than what I usually would.
Yeah.
So I'm not on a strict diet or nothing.
No.
But where I can, I do try and eat healthy, but to me, I can get away with having the cheat food.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what advice would you give to anyone that's trying to cut weight or lose weight? What advice would you give to them?
Well, I would say to them, you know, try and cut down some of them sweet stuff that you're having. Because I know that doesn't help. In terms of intensity, you have to have your intensity high. Like, someone could say to me, oh yeah, I went for a job, but what intensity was that job?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You need to be working up a sweat. And I'm all about high intensity, you know, HIIT workouts.
Yeah.
Short, sweet, but you're working hard, you know, so.
Of course.
Yeah, always up for that.
Okay. I'm going to do a quick Q&A. Okay. Yeah. So, 400 or 400 hurdles?
400 hurdles.
Garage, grime, or hip-hop?
All garage.
All garage, yeah?
Garage.
All garage, all day long. Big Shacks or Stormzy?
Oh, Big Shacks.
What's your warm-up track?
Oh, my God. My warm-up track. You know what? I don't listen to music.
No?
When I'm training.
What about competing? That one track that just goes, I'm ready now, I'm in a zone.
It's going to definitely be a garage tune.
Yeah.
Or something like a grime tune, because you'll hear them mention, like, maybe the area that you're from or brought up. So it might think, no, I'm proud to be from East London, do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But my playlist is so random when it comes to, like, warming up.
Okay.
Yeah, because sometimes I might have some slow tunes on it or something. Yeah,
it's weird, yeah.
So I don't have a slow track, sorry, I don't.
Okay, best impression of Zaha. All right, Power, Scandal, or Empire?
Power, come on.
Cool. Marry, kiss, or avoid? Tyrese, Anthony Joshua, and Ghost from Power.
Oh,
God, that's a good question. Okay. I might get in trouble for this. Okay, I'm engaged here, but listen, don't matter. Right. Marry. Ooh, ghost.
Okay.
Kiss and you're sure. Mm-hmm. Avoid Tammy Susan.
Okay. Kind of got that right then. Alright, thank you very much.
Oh, that was good.
Take care.